Yes. Drive the dark down away. Yeah. Give her up in to Glenn. Fill us with the light. Fill us with the light. Lord, I need you to fill us with the light.
My life, I put none before thee, cause since I was a youngster, I came to know that you was the only way to go.
So I had to grow and come to and understand it. And I'm down with the king, so now I'm demanding that you tell me who you down with, see. Cause all I know is that I'm down with G-O-D. You down with G-O-D?
Yeah, you know me.
You down with G-O-D?
Yeah, you know me.
You down with G-O-D?
Yeah, you know me.
You down with G-O-D?
The most wonderful time of the year, with the kids jingle belling and everyone telling you be of good cheer. It's the most wonderful time of the year. It's the happiest season of all, with those holiday and gay happy meetings when friends come to call. It's the happiest season of all. There'll be parties for hosting, marshmallows for toasting, and caroling out in the snow. There'll be scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time of the year.
Toasting and caroling out in the snow.
scary ghost stories and tales of the glories of Christmases long, long ago. It's the most wonderful time of the year. There'll be much mistletoeing and hearts will be glowing when loved ones are near. It's the most wonderful time. Yes, the most wonderful time. Oh, the most wonderful time of the
spirits up, we're here tonight, and that's enough. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. Simply having a wonderful Christmas time. The party's on, the feeling's here, that only comes this time of year.
Christmas time. welcome. I'm trying to hold off for as many parents that can be here as we can, but we got to start. You guys ready to start the show? Hey. All right. If you guys, we're going to close sales in the back, and then we're going to start in a couple minutes. So if you can find your seats, I'll come back out in just about 2 minutes. I'm going to give you guys all a chance to close the sales down and everyone to find their seats, and then we'll do the welcome. We'll talk through concert etiquette, and then we'll get ready to run. All right? We've got about 2 minutes. If you guys want to come in from the back and go ahead and sit down. Okay, welcome. Welcome to the Instrumental Christmas Concert. We are glad that you guys are here. How many of you were here earlier today for church? Yeah. And last night, was anyone here last night for the drama? Yeah. It is, week after week, I am reminded of how talented our students are and how much dedication it takes from you to send them here and put them through. And it's just been a blessing as we go through these last few weeks. Musically, you get to see all the work that's gone in this semester. So we are really excited about finishing this up tonight. And so I would like to welcome you. And we're going to close the sales. I'll give you a little preview of how this is going to go. We have three sections. In between the sections, we will serve food. Okay, this first section is going to be a preview. How many of you, I like communication. How many of you are going to be at Sounds of the Season tomorrow? How many of you bought a table or bought tickets? Okay, this beginning section is a taste, a preview of what that will be like. And I do this mainly because small group performance is so crucial to the success of a musician. And doing it in front of a lot of people, it brings nerves, but it really promotes growth. And the other reason is a lot of people, we sell out every year, and a lot of you guys may not have gotten tickets to that. I want you to hear a little bit of the work that they do independently. Sounds of the Season is our big fundraiser dinner where we sell tables and tickets, and our students work in small groups together, putting together duets and trios and saxophone ensembles. You see a string quartet over there. There's a variety of music with a variety of skill levels, a variety of talents, but they all work in small groups to provide music. And it's really exciting. Tomorrow, it's mostly background music for our dinner program. But tonight, you'll get to hear one song from almost all of them as a preview of where we're going. So that's section one. At the end of that section, we will close the curtain. When the curtain closes, you are welcome to go back. Our costume contest goes then. Top winner gets $100. I can't qualify, but I think I did good this year. Second place, my kids can't either. So when they come up here and, you know, they go through the line and everyone goes, oh, they can't win. It's like a radio station. You can't win if you're related. But we'll do the costume contest and then the full orchestra. This year, we're back with a full orchestra. And Sinfonietta will perform. When we close those curtains, we'll have the second costume contest. The food sales will be open. And concert band will come up and we'll finish the night. At the end of the evening, you are welcome to take a few minutes, take some pictures of these awesome decorations that the students did. Pat your student on the back, tell them you love them, and then you can help us break down, because the sooner we get this broken down, the sooner we go home tonight, because they use this facility for a lot of other things. So at the end of the night, hopefully some of you, will help us break all of this down, and then we will go home. And then for those of you in Sounds of the Season, we'll see you again tomorrow. We're doing this all weekend. So thank you so much for coming. And I'm ready to go. The kids are back here. They're ready to go. So let's start with a word of prayer, and then we're going to just hit it. Father, thank you for the ability to gather together. Thank you for the talents that you've given these students, for the commitment you've given to the parents, for the willingness that you have given them to believe in Christian education, for GCA for providing us with an atmosphere that promotes your name. We pray that this evening is in honor of you, and it's fun, and it's a time where we come together and we celebrate your name. We pray that you ease the stress and ease the tensions, and for safe travel, for good tests and finals for all of our students, and we love you. Amen. Thank you.
Thank you.
Yes, let's give it up for all of them one more time. Such a good job. That's scary. You know, it's easier when you have a band of 40 or an orchestra of 40, but when it's three, it's a little frightening. So I'm really proud of all of them. We are going to open up sales. Students, my kids, if you would like to come up and be part of the costume contest, Dean Nesmith will be in tradition running the costume contest. Sales will be open. I hope you enjoyed a preview of tomorrow's dinner. It's going to be wonderful. And we'll see you with full orchestra and sinfonietta in about 10 minutes.
Good evening, gentlemen. We're about to start the costume contest in about 5 minutes, but during that 5 minutes, we do ask everybody to get up, stretch your legs, reach behind you, get your wallet out of your pocket, and take your wallet back there and purchase food. We want to support the band, and you're hungry anyway. Face it, you're hungry. And if you're not hungry, if you go back there and look at some of the things they have, you're going to be hungry, so just get it over with and go and give them all your money. Hey, if you are going to be in the costume contest, please do go over to this side of the stage. We're going to have you come up in just a little bit. Now, for the people that are still sitting here, all the people that are sitting down for the contest, you also have an important part to play. I know there's not everybody's paying attention, and that's okay because we want people to be back there spending money. But if you are still here sitting down, you're part of the costume contest. I'm going to pull somebody up to the microphone. I'm going to introduce them. And then you are going to either show your appreciation a lot or show your appreciation a little bit. And the way you show your appreciation is to take out your cell phone, tap it so I can see that it's a cell phone, and wave it back and forth. If you think that somebody dressed up, and they're kind of cute, a little bit nice, you can just hold your phone up like this. If somebody dressed up, and this is really, really good, then tap your phone and wave it back and forth like this. And if the costume that you see is so fantastic that you're actually fooled, it might actually be Santa Claus, then you need to wave your phone like crazy so I can tell that you're excited about that. Okay, let's practice that. Everybody that is still sitting down, please take out your cell phone. And let's act like somebody just came up. And this is Rudolph, the red-nosed reindeer. And they're coming all the way from the North Pole. And what do you think? Good job. You're doing it right. Okay, remember, if you think it's a little bit cute, just hold it. If you think it's really good, wave it back and forth. And if you think it's fantastic, then wave it hard. Okay, good job. Okay, all the people that would like to be in this costume contest, please come up to the front in that corner. We're going to still wait a minute so the people that are in the contest can get ready. And I'm going to give you a little bit of Christmas trivia while we're waiting. Okay, first one. If you know this answer, then you can shout it out. In what country did they start the tradition of bringing a Christmas tree into your house? I heard Germany. That's correct. Good job. Okay, give yourself 1 point. Or here. I'll wave my phone for you. Good job, Germany. Okay, next one. In the classic Charles Dickens book, The Christmas Carol, how many ghosts appear? Correct answer is 4. Remember, first Bob Marley, not Bob Marley. Okay. You watched a different Christmas Carol than I did. But then you have the Christmas past, Christmas present, and Christmas future. And with Mr. Marley, that's 4. Okay, next one. In the movie Home Alone, when Macaulay Culkin got stuck at home alone, where did his family go? Paris is correct. Okay, while I'm doing this, costume people, please get ready to come up. Okay, this is an interesting one. In what country was eggnog invented? Think of a country that eats really weird food. I heard it over here. England. Good job. England started eggnog. Okay, here's a math question. If you got every single gift from every single verse of the 12 days of Christmas, how many gifts would you have? I heard 105. It's more. More than that. Less than 2,000. If you add up every time they sing the gift, you would end up with 364 gifts, which makes a lot of sense because that's how many days there are in the year. And then on Christmas, you get all of those. Okay, we're going to do one more, and then we're going to go and do the costumes. Okay, this question. In what Christmas movie did Tom Hanks, the actor Tom Hanks, play 6 different parts? I hope a lot of you guys got that. Polar Express. Okay, I'm going to take the microphone off and come over this way. Okay, we have a lot of people here that are ready for the costume contest. And this is the way it's going to work for the people to come up. I'm going to call somebody's name. I'm going to tell you what they're dressed as. And then they're going to have the opportunity to talk into the microphone. They don't have to. Some of them will decide to talk into the microphone. And some of them will just pass. But then we'll ask you to give your vote. Remember how to vote? You take your cell phone, hold it up, or wave it back and forth, or wave it like crazy. Okay, the first one we have is Santa's helper, Gerda. Gerda, are you here? Okay, Gerda is not going to come up for this one. Okay, let's go to the next one. We have Anani. And actually, Anani, I'm going to let you tell everybody what you are.
I am Christmas Elmo.
Christmas Elmo. If you lean over, they can see why. There we go. Good job. Okay, thank you very much. Okay, next one we have is Santa's helper, Gerda, right here.
Ho, ho, ho.
Very good. All right, thank you very much. Okay, next we have Van Scott. Van Scott, come on up. Van Scott, here you go.
Some people say I'm cold-hearted, but I can say I got ice in my veins.
Jack Frost. Good job. Okay, next we have Garrett Van Manen. Here you go, Garrett.
Hey, my name is the elf who stole Christmas. Thank you.
Not exactly a nightmare, but very creative. Okay, good job. Now we have Samantha and Etta. Come on up. Would you like to talk?
I am Jadis from Queen of Narnia. And you will address me as such.
She is the White Witch, and she makes it snow always and never Christmas.
Oh, yes, and this is my trustworthy reindeer, and she pulls me around for joy.
Good job. And she makes very good Turkish delight. Next, we have Silas. Come on up, Silas. Hey, Silas.
Can you hear it?
I don't hear anything.
Do you hear it?
Good job. He's from Polar Express. Next, we have Matthew.
I just like smiling. Smiling's my favorite.
Good job, good job. I know his four favorite food groups. Does anybody know his four favorite food groups? Candy, candy cane, candy corn, and syrup, if you watch the Elf movie. All right, Miss Alexa, come on up.
I'm Olaf, and I like warm hugs.
Very good. Hey, hands up. Good job. Now we have Abraham, Edmund, Emma, Ellie, and Ariana.
Ho, ho, ho. Have a Merry Christmas, period.
Nay, nay, nay.
All right, we got Santa Claus and four reindeer. Go ahead, what do you think? Good job. We have another one. Come on up.
Hi, my name's Kevin McAllister. It's my home and I must defend it.
Very good. I'm checking to see if you have a tarantula with you. No tarantula. Hey, once again, for Home Alone. All right, ladies and gentlemen, that's the end of the first round of the costume contest. Later in the concert, we're going to have another stop and another break, and we're going to have the finalists come back up. And at that time, we'll find out who the winners are, and we'll give them their prizes. We still have a couple of minutes for you guys to go and spend money, so please go back. If you were helping judge, now go help buy candy.
Hey, okay. All right, if you guys can start making your way back. Sales, we're going to close sales now. If the rest of you can find your seats, we will start the next portion of our program as soon as you are ready. The front half is ready. They're eager to go. I know you're back there and you're enjoying yourselves, but you can make your way to your seats, and we'll start. I do like to wait until everyone's in their seat and ready, because these kids have worked really hard all semester, and I want to make sure that we're giving them the respect that we give them. So as you make your way to your seats, as soon as you guys are in, I'll poke my head out, make sure we're ready to go, and we'll start full orchestra. All right, we're ready to start the next portion of the show. I still see some people lingering out there, but I think we're ready to go. You are about to hear our full orchestra. I'll tell you a little bit more about it later, but it involves many of our scholarship wind players. And we have attempted to meet third periods. We've gotten ourselves out of the mornings, but we have had to do a couple of our 7:15 in the morning rehearsals, which they love. Absolutely love. But I'm excited because full orchestra, again, offers a whole nother different challenge musically that is really awesome for these kids. So as soon as I go back there, we'll get ready to go and we'll present the full orchestra. If you had a solo, stand up in that. If you had a solo, stand up. That was you. That was you. Solo, stand up. Yeah. Good job. All right. Wins, thank you very much. You may exit stage right. While they, I'm not going to use that. While they are exiting, like I said, we have a lot of our scholarship twin players coming into play. It's really exciting. I love strings with anything makes anything better. Strings with a spotlight would make the spotlight better, but strings with anything makes it better. I love putting these guys, I need to just say something about this group. They're like the workhorse of the instrumental music department. You see them, we had them out Thursday in double quartets. Raise your hand if you played in the double quartet Thursday at Advent Murray for their Christmas tree lighting. The Vivaldi strings, raise your hand if you were the Vivaldi strings. You saw them today. Raise your hand if you played in the praise music this year. All of you, raise your hand. Raise your hand. So they do a little bit of everything, which I think is great. They get to learn a whole variety of music, which I think is really cool. But yes, you've heard them last Sabbath with the strings, and then they were out on tour. Pieces of them are doing different things. So they work really, really hard, and I'm excited about that. And adding winds to that is really cool. I got to do orchestra. I was blessed to do it at Southern, and I love the opportunity to have these guys doing it here. So we're going to head into the next portion. No curtain closed for this. We're going to head into the next portion of our show, which is Sinfonietta. They don't even need me. That's good. And what is it in the Christmas in the South without a good traditional hoedown? That was called Holiday Hoedown. This one will be a little more recognizable to you.
Thank you.
You're welcome to sing with us. As you know the songs, if you've been here before, you know I like crowd participation. I think it encourages the kids. I do want to take a moment. Shauna Wood is back there somewhere, but I want to thank all of you guys for supporting us, for bringing food, for support all throughout the whole year. But Shauna has organized this now for a little bit. And thank you, Shauna, and Jeff, and everyone that's helping them. I think we are in the process of looking for someone new to take over. So if you would like the honor of lots of hours of volunteer work with no pay, talk to Shauna at the end of the evening, and maybe you can help in that transition. But we always have our parent, unofficial parent booster club kind of run the back, and that helps us kind of fund the program and what we're doing. So thank you guys so very much for that. We're going to go into our next song now, which is God Rest You Merry Gentlemen. You know, for Hannah on the solo, which was a weird duet. Yes, that was a sweet from the Nutcracker that just keeps wanting to run. It just wants to run faster and faster and faster. That's one of those pieces that the music is so great, but the actual play is weird. I was telling them, it's weird. There's, a rat prince, and, I don't understand all that. But I love the music, so we do the music because it's a classic. We can skip that as Christmas music, Christmas movies. We don't watch that in the house. It scares the little ones. We're going to finish with my favorite Christmas song. It's every year. I get really excited. It's how I know Christmas is here. It's the first one I turn on. And no, it's not what you're thinking. Well, if you've been here before, you know it. But you guys know I love Mariah Carey's Christmas, but that's not what this is. This is a classic, wonderful, it makes you feel like traditional Christmas is here. And we're going to finish with that. Aiden, before we do that, actually, Esther, stand up for me. She's not going to want to. Esther Reese is here playing with us this evening. Yes. And Darby Schultz used to be Jones when she was here. Stand up, Darby. Darby was a concert master. When were you concert master here? 10. Oh. Darby was my concert master 10 years ago. My name is Mark, and I'm getting old. Yikes. But I'm excited. Her husband was here playing baritone, or euphonium, in the woodwinds, and he's going to be playing. We have some guests. I tell all my alumni, you are always welcome to come back. Once you're part of the family, you're always part of the family. And if you're out there, or if you're watching, I can send you music. PDF works great. You're welcome to come back and play with us at any time. So we will finish our set with my favorite Christmas song. Can you guys neigh like a horse? Can we try that? I lost my horse, Winnie, a long time ago, and I don't have can we try going, neigh? Ready? Okay, so when I point at you, you have to do it, or it's going to ruin the whole thing. Let's try one more time. Ready? Okay. Give yourselves a round of applause. That was awesome. Sinfonietta, folks. Sinfonietta. Stand up.
Ladies and gentlemen, once again, food is being sold. The gift, or the food tables at the back are open. Please make sure you go and spend money. We do have the finals now for the contest, the costume contest. We have four groups that made it all the way to the end. And after we have that contest, then we're going to show you the winners of who's in first, second, and third place of those four groups that continued on. Now, I talked to those four groups and I let them know that they made it to the finals. So we're going to give them a minute to come over here to my right so they can come up and introduce themselves to you one more time. While we're doing that, I'm going to give you a couple more pieces of Christmas trivia. Okay, in what country is it very customary to have Kentucky Fried Chicken for your Christmas dinner? I didn't hear it yet. It's a special gift and customary to have Kentucky Fried Chicken in Japan for Christmas. Okay, next one. This should be an easy one for some people. How many of the Santa's reindeer's names start with the letter D, as in Dean? Anybody? How many reindeer's names start with the letter D? I heard one, I heard two, I heard three. The correct answer is three on Dasher and Dancer. And then later there's Donner. So there's three D's. The Donner had a party. We won't go there. Okay, next one. This is an interesting one. People talk about Christmas pudding. I don't think Americans have Christmas pudding that often, but what is a customary thing to find in the bottom of a Christmas pudding? Walnut? The correct answer is a coin. I didn't know if anybody said that, but there's usually a coin in the bottom of a Christmas pudding. Okay, next one. In what city has always provided the Christmas tree for Trafalgar Square in London? I had no idea about this one, but I was wondering if anybody might know it. The correct answer is Oslo, Norway. And I guess Oslo, Norway is famous for its Christmas trees. Okay, once again, the people that are doing the costume contest, please come down here. We're going to call your names up in just a minute. The final groups, you need to be over here. I don't see any of the groups yet. Okay, final question, trivia question for Christmas. Up to this date, what is the best selling Christmas song? According to the Guinness Book of World Records, what is the best selling Christmas song? A lot of people are saying Mariah Carey. Wait, I heard one over here. Not Jingle Bells. The best selling Christmas song up to this date is Bing Crosby, White Christmas. I heard somebody say that over here. All right. At this time, we need one more judge to come up. I asked another judge to come and help count on this side of the this side of the room. Okay, I see them there. Okay, let's do a practice. Remember, how do you show your appreciation for a costume? Get out your phone. If you think their costume is kind of good, hold your phone up like this. If you think it's really good, wave it back and forth. That counts as 2 points. If you think it's fantastic, wave your phone really hard back and forth, and that counts as 3 points. And we're going to take the total amount of points that we see and add them to that entry. And whoever has the most will get in first and second and third place. Okay, here we go. The first person that's going to come up this time for his entry is Matt Taylor.
The best way to spread Christmas cheer is through a song for all to hear.
All right, good job. Hey, remember, you can say something, but with your group, you don't have to say something. Okay, do you have it written down? How many you have? Got it written down. Okay. Next, we have Van Scott. Please come on up.
I made this.
Very good. Good job. Okay, for our next one, we have Garrett Van Manen with the elf that stole Christmas. Well, he stole it, so he might be hiding. Or he might have been arrested. We'll come back to him. For our next one, we have Abraham, Edmund, Emma, Ellie, and Ariana, Santa and the Reindeer.
Not quite sure where all my reindeers went, but I have three reindeers. So yeah, that's an update.
We see one reindeer.
Oh, on. Wait, get up here, right now.
Yeah, the missing reindeer.
We found it. We found the missing reindeer.
It must be tough to take care of that many reindeer. All right, for Santa and the reindeer who have been found. Good job. Okay, and now we need the last one, the elf that stole Christmas, Garrett Van Manen. All right, the elf that stole Christmas. Good job. Okay, judges, please come over to this side. That's all the applicants. We're going to count up the total of votes, and I'll be back here in just a moment to tell you who the winners are. All right, entries. Please get ready to come back up here. We have some winners. Coming in fourth place. Sorry, you don't get a prize, but we're happy that you dressed up and we appreciate you. Santa and the Reindeer, thank you very much for coming in fourth place. Okay, for the first cash prize, coming in third place, Jack Frost, Van Scott. Please come up and get your prize. Jack Frost.
Thank you.
Okay, I'm about to call up second place. Second place earning however much is in here. Second place is the elf that stole Christmas, Garrett Van Manen. Congratulations, Garrett. I hear him somewhere behind me. He's coming out here. I know he's coming because I heard people saying his name. Garrett Van Manen. Okay, are there any representatives that would... Okay, here he is. Second place. And first place this year, winning first place, I think he won an award last year also, for being Elf from Elf, Matthew Taylor. Good job, Matthew. Make sure next year you're ready to dress up for the costume contest at Christmas, and at the spring concert, we're also going to have another costume contest. Pay attention to the program to find out what the theme is going to be. We'll continue on with the program.
last chance to get those treats, folks. Go on back, get some treats, get something to eat. You know you're hungry.
All right, if you guys could gather in, we're getting ready to go. If we can collect all the students, and we're going to stop sales. Don't worry if you didn't get one of the awesome corn dogs that KC made, or if you didn't, maybe we're out, I don't know. But we will do sales again at the end of the night and get rid of everything. So if you guys can come in, we'll start in about 5 minutes as soon as you're ready. Faculty, if you can help get the students back in, and we'll be ready to go. All right, we are ready to go. If those of you that are standing in the back talking and hanging out, that's wonderful, but it's time to come join us. Thank you. I appreciate you guys being a part of this and finding your seats. Thank you very much. We will finish this evening out. We are starting with concert band now, and then we will do some sales in the back at the end, like I said. But in just a moment, we will start concert band. I think I heard you guys singing. Were you all singing loud? Yeah, good, 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 good. All right, before we get too far in it, I want to say a couple thank yous to some people. Randy and Michael in the back. You heard it earlier. Randy's been running sound. Michael's been with them all weekend, and I'm very grateful for them, along with Kaylee and Brianna, who are hiding over here in the corner that help running this stuff all the time. You know, it's... This is the village. It takes a village to raise the kids. Well, we have a really cool village here, so that's good. Cindy Tomaszewski's playing clarinet for us behind me. Yes, thank you all. I have a couple special thanks to guys. If you've been here a while now, you know they're regulars here. But I have to thank them every year because they put in such an immense amount of time or travel distance now, because what Dennis hasn't had in time here, he's made up in miles. But Dennis Starkey is back, folks, playing trumpet, so thank you. I don't know how he comes back from Ohio, but I've got him hooked, so that's cool. And then Jim Teal on the tuba, who comes in and plays all the time. In fact, Jim teaches some of the lessons, and he worked with the trombones that you heard, and he arranged the song that we played, and tomorrow at Sounds of the Season, you'll hear some of that. So thank you, Jim, so much. And then Brian Avery, who's sitting out there, I won't make you come up if you don't want to come up, but Brian Avery is like my right-hand man here. He co-teaches with me. He does all the lessons for them. He's been awesome. Brian, this is for you. I'll leave it down here. We gave him the night off. I said, just come and sit and enjoy instead of doing all the work for a while. So I just want to say thank you. There's so many people involved in making this happen on all levels. And like I said, we couldn't do it without everyone kicking in and doing their parts. One last thing is I want to say thanks to the kids for putting all the hours in to transform this gym into a nice little Christmas concert. Andrew Schultz, go ahead and stand up. Or at least wave. Yes, that's Darby's husband who's playing. I know I mentioned him earlier. And I do want to take a moment to thank my family, my wife, who has been without me for a couple days as we're doing this, and my kids, who you see up here. I think they just love coming up and dressing up. But it's a sacrifice to be married to an education person in boarding school, and I am so grateful and thankful that they are so supportive. So I wanted to say thank you to them. My father-in-law is back there running lights, by the way, as well, so it's a family affair. Yeah. Okay, so this is becoming a regular thing. Every concert, it feels like, I talk about Aiden Garapi. It seems like. But Aiden keeps growing and developing, and we do more and more cool stuff. And so if you were here last year, you heard he arranged a hymn with orchestra. And this year, he's arranged a song for concert band. And it's hard. It's really good. But the talent level that it takes, and Jim Teal is his teacher. So just a little shout out to both of them. But Aiden has arranged this whole thing. He has been working with the band. I've been helping a little bit, but putting it all together. And this is, you're going to be shocked that a high school student has written an arrangement of music that is this complicated and this good and just so wonderful. So I know I shouldn't keep going on about him, but it's really awesome. So he's going to conduct this next piece, and it's called Rejoice. He said he had a 10-minute description of what he wanted to... No? No. Okay. All right. So he's just going to conduct.
I do want to say a thank you to Mr. Torzi, who's been my teacher, for like taught me piano, and I would not be here without him. So thank you to Mr. Torzi.
Thank you.
Did you hear something? There it is again. It sounds like a clatter.
It was a clatter.
It was a clatter.
Ho, ho, ho.
Hey, what are you doing up there?
Ho, ho, ho.
Dad, you killed Santa.
I didn't kill Santa.
Yes, you did. Oh. He's dead. You killed him.
What is this? Look at me, buddy.
Santa! You are Santa!
Good to see you, buddy. Good to see you, buddy. Say hi to the family. All right. Whew. Well, thank you all. Sorry to interrupt this program, but I needed to share a few early Christmas gifts. Maybe my helpers can stand over on the side here. Thank you very much. Okay, now I have a few gifts to give you, but first of all, I need to share a few Christmas words of wisdom. How do you know when Santa's around? You can always sense his presence. All right. What kind of photos do elves take? Elfies! Thank you, drummer. Thank you. Why was a snowman looking through a pile of carrots? He was picking his nose. No? No? Okay. Okay, I have a few gifts here. Do I have an Ira Mills Junior? Help with the sack. Hold this. You don't know Ira, do you? Hang on. Let me find. What do I have here? Find the butterfly. So there's a story, Ira, that I know about. Apparently, there was a caterpillar. Who else knows about this caterpillar? It's a big caterpillar but it's still a caterpillar. And Ira saw this caterpillar, and what did you say, Ira?
Bro, it was scary, dog. I don't know.
He screamed like a girl. Let's hear it, Ira. What did you say?
I don't know. I don't remember.
Okay, so for our gifts for you, just so you can understand that caterpillars turn into beautiful butterflies. Remember that. So you don't get so scared every time you see a caterpillar. Okay, what's cold and annoying at breakfast? An avalanche! Oh, that was a good one. No? Okay. All right, do I have Hannah Walker and Ari Forrester? Come on up, please. Hannah Walker and Ari Forrester. Helmets. Now, when you signed up for band, you may not have known it was a contact sport. Yes. Now, most of us don't get in the habit of throwing our instruments around the room. But these two ladies in the front row have had a duck and dodge certain percussion instruments recently. So Santa wanted to provide you with some head protection. Now the percussion section can throw all the sticks they want. Maybe not. Don't do that. Okay. Ho, ho. It's a weird talent that I have when I can identify what's inside a wrapped present. I mean, it's a gift. Okay. Do I have a Zach DeChickis in the room? He has the... Mr. DeChickis. So dangerous, always skateboarding and biking home. We thought, while you should use a helmet, you could borrow one of these nice ladies' helmets one of these days. But perhaps this bell will be a nice way to remind all of the people driving the road that you're coming through. Just let them know that you're there. And Mr. DeChickis has a unique sense of style. And we wanted to add to his wardrobe with this nice pair of cut-off shorts. You don't have one just like this, do you?
Very close.
Very close. Okay, well, you can add it to your collection. Thank you, Mr. DeChickis. Give him a round of applause. Okay. Okay, what do you call a search engine? A search engine that sings Christmas songs. Michael Google. No. Okay, all right. I'm new at this, so sorry. All right. Do we have Mr. Landon Stoner in the room? Come on down, Mr. Stoner. No. Oh, my. Very well. Very well done. Hello. Thank you. You've been naughty this year. I understand that Mr. Stoner comes to church without a tie. All the boys here understand what the dress code is at church. Sometimes you don't wear a jacket either. So in case of those times, we bought you a tie befitting your wardrobe. Congratulations, Mr. Stoner. Thank you so much. All right. How much does Santa pay for his sleigh? Nothing. It was on the house. Okay. Do we have a Bruce Bogus and Alisa Sorensen. Do we have a Bruce Bogus? Maybe Alisa Sorensen is at home, but perhaps she's watching from the stream. So everybody say hello to Mrs. Sorensen at home for being home with her daughter. Now, Mr. Bogus and Mrs. Sorensen, I understand, are brand new vice principals. And they're doing a great, great job, very wonderful job. And at this time of year, with all of the lack of jobs out there, potentially, if you ever need a job, I could always use some really good elf assistants up at the North Pole. So I just want you to know that I got you guys. There's another one. Elf ears, but you'll have to provide your own elf costume. Just make sure it is North Pole appropriate. Well, I'll see you guys maybe someday up there. Thank you so much. Oh, oh. And finally, Mr. Torsney. Mr. Torsney has been on a little bit of a carb deficit lately. It's made him a little hangry. And you're not you when you're hungry, Mr. Torsney. So we got you a Snickers bar. But not only that, Mr. Torsney has a very difficult time keeping track of his stuff. He loses his phone. He loses his keys. But only because you have 75 assistants to help keep track of all your things. Apparently, some elves told me you also lose your drumsticks. So we have two new pink drumsticks just for you. Pink phone case, pink drumsticks. All right. Freshly painted pink drumsticks. Thank you very much, everybody. Merry Christmas. Merry Christmas. Ho, ho, ho. We're going to go this way.
Yeah, thank you, Santa. Our
ho, ho, ho. Thank you so much.
New Santa. Don't worry. No Santas were killed in that video. This is kind of off the cuff, but I do want to take a moment to thank Dr. Gerard, who's sitting out there, for 15 years of being Santa for me. And nobody likes doing this, ironically, but he, for 15 years, was awesome and would reluctantly put the costume on. And I guess it becomes part of the principal job. So it got passed on to, oh, well, you don't know who that was. So it's, forget it. That's our new Santa. No. So, hey, thank you guys so much. This is our last song. I know it's getting late. Good news, band, we're not breaking this down tonight. We're going to come back and do it when we get back. We just will break that down. Thank you guys so much. You guys have been awesome. Your kids are awesome. We've had a wonderful semester. We're going to finish the night with, I think, what the girls' dorm has shivers to every year, what they hear this song. But I do love this song, and was it the most streamed song, the Mariah? Is that the most streamed song ever? Is that what Doug said? No, what was it? A close second. That's my favorite movie, those of you that were with me a couple years ago. But we're going to finish tonight with Mariah Carey. When we're done, take some pictures with the kids, and then we're going to break stuff down. My request is the walls I want to keep intact. So, band, when you guys move those walls over, Coble would like to use some of those. So we're just going to carry them over and leave them in the old gym and let them come get them tomorrow. But thank you guys so much. I hope you have a wonderful holiday season and a Merry Christmas, and we love you guys.
Thank you.
it up for the soloists. Yes. Rest of the band, stand up. Woo! Thank you guys very much. You have a wonderful holiday season. We'll see you tomorrow at SoCal Sounds of the Season, and have a wonderful night.